heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah, hallelujah.
I called Death Row. I basically was at the river and watched this fish sort of take its last. And once they take their last, then they lose their green and their red colors and they go back to gray. And they slowly, that one up there is showing them as they lose their colors. And the female is more jellied and putrefied than the male. And the male has got that big dip in his face, and he's more recently dead because he still has the green and the pink tones, even though they're fading away from him. And I also like to hope and believe that you can smell the smell of those fish dying. And yet, when they die, it's not the end, it's the beginning of the rest of the cycle. So, what I wanted to do is I wanted to read you my words and then explain to you my words and how the words relate to the imagery. Okay, so it's merrily, merrily, swimming upstream. Hallelujah, hallelujah. River dancers, salmon fillet, death row. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Spawning fire nesters, spawned to death. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Fish fertilizer, prophet spawned, creator and robe. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So those are my words. And I just wanted to say about my words, I'm gonna read you what I have so I remember it. I wanted an artistic statement that would reflect with words what one sees with their eyes. The visual language, which is this, and the written word had to relate strongly to one another. Two streams of consciousness describing one idea. The pictures leave lots of space for the viewer's own interpretation, and that's really important for me. When I paint, I like to believe that I'm setting the stones in place for a story to develop and rush over those stones. And I don't want to tell you what story you're to think. I want you to think your own story, but it's developed by what I'm laying down for you to see. So my words continue. The pictures leave lots of space for the viewer's own interpretation, and I wanted the same spaciousness in words. So on reflection, I came to the realization that I wanted the power of a prayer and the rhythm of a poem and the melody of a song. So my words are written in a style that reflects the purposefulness of prayer, poetry, and song. So that's what it's about for me. And I tell a lot of people I spend hours and hours and hours alone. So I have a lot of time to develop what my full theory is. And you won't know my full theory about why I paint unless I had time to express to you. And that rarely happens with visual art. But I did want to lay down enough of a story so that you would stop at my piece and add your own story. So I'm just gonna go through some of the words and then so, merrily, merrily, and then I love the idea because it's sort of like row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. So it was happy, and it made you think of your childhood and your youth and your mom and everything that nurtured you to this point. So it was happy, and it gave you a lull of happiness, right? So merrily, merrily, And then the next line is swimming upstream. And if you can imagine swimming upstream, I can't really imagine it. And I've gone to the rivers, I've gone to the Added River, I've gone to the Eagle River, I've gone to the Perry River, the north part of it. I've hiked all many, many places, the Upper Adams. And to think about swimming upstream. So swimming upstream, this is my ideas of swimming upstream. This one, it's rougher. This painting, it's a bit rougher. There's a big eddy pulling you down into here. So how do you swim out of that? This is supposed to be night, and yet something's sparkling on it. So you get to see, do they sense it? Is the moon helping them, pulling them in the right direction? This is the calmness of the water, when it's still and it's easy. But when can it ever be easy upstream? I don't know. And so another line, and then joyful hallelujah, hallelujah, because they're doing what they're supposed to do, and I love Leonard Cohen. And then river dancers and salmon fillet. This is my river dancers and my salmon fillet. So the river dancers is like you're a salmon and you're right up and you're swimming and you can see everything. You can see their skin, you can see their scales, you can see them gleam and the way the sun hits them. The water sticking to them, their faces plowing through, going upstream, and yet I still want to eat them. And I still wonder, as these wild salmon come down on their run, and there's these fish farms right by their runs who are giving them fish lice and diseases, and when I eat them, how is their body that's full of horrible disease, how's that affecting me, and yet I still want to eat. So that's the dilemma now, right? There's this dilemma. It's just not all joyful hallelujah. It still is, but man, what's starting to happen? Then the next one is death row. So death row. My salmon, when I was at the river, I took a picture of a Chinook, and it was just like this. The eggs were coming out. It was gray, it was dead, but I love this idea of the caper red. And my kid, he told me that Red Riding Hood, well, Mom, don't you know that Red Riding Hood is about menstruation and becoming a woman? And that's why she's got a red cape? And so then I realized, you've never heard that one either. Anyways, I thought it was good. So then I painted this like huge red just for that idea, you know, that idea about becoming a woman, losing your virginity, dropping your eggs, eggs that make it, eggs that don't make it. So eggs that don't make it, the end, the death, right? And not getting your full ride, not getting your full journey to your biological end, but yet you had the journey, right? You had the journey. Okay, there's a sad hallelujah. Still hallelujah because you had the journey, but it's not overwhelming. And then the next one is spawning fire nesters. That's what I call this one, spawning fire nesters. And I call it spawning fire nesters. This one's laying her eggs as she's flying upstream. She's laying her eggs. And I have a friend named Michelle, and Michelle works for DFO. And Michelle told me, and I'll do my little dance for you, imitating what salmon do. Michelle told me that the female, she uses her nose and she digs in the sand and she finds a perfect spot where she's going to lay her eggs. She lays her eggs, they come out, they hit the rocks. The man is guarding her. There's a man somewhere and he's guarding her. He's trying to keep all the other men away. She swims away, he comes around and he lays, he fertilizes those eggs. The job is done. So I love the idea of being nesting. My friend Michelle told me that they actually nest like a bird. They dig with their noses. So I love the idea of nesting. And they're successful, right? They did it. They've done the deed, the journey. The journey was successful. And then when you think about all the things that are stopping them from being successful, holy Toledo, just first of all swimming upstream. And then this one here is called Spawn to Death. I don't know, I think that's glorious, to be spawned to death. So, what I wrote, biological job complete, and the male and female in a loving embrace in death. A heavy, pungent smell on the nose, on our noses, right? That's what I hope for. And then I also see it like it's a heart shape, but the heart shape is coming in from the side. They're in a heart. They're touching one another. So they're truly friends, even though she died a lot before he died. And then it goes on, there's a joyful hallelujah again, and then there's, my next words are fish fertilizer, because these fish, they died, they did the journey, they were successful, a lot of fish aren't, but these ones were in my imagination, right? It all lives here. It doesn't live anywhere else but in my head, and I didn't see this all put together until it was on this wall. So they become fish fertilizer, and they feed the glorious trembling aspens that grow along the river. And if you listen really carefully, you'll hear the trembling aspens. They go like this, sort of the noise that the tails make flapping in the river. It's a similar sort of sound. And then the leaves come, and they fall off, and they fall into the rocks. And all of this, there's the look of the lines behind my painting, and then there's the symbol of the fish in the row, sort of forming like the sun rising or setting behind the tree. But really, all of this is feeding all of this, and it's feeding my eagles that are tied to the fish lines. It's feeding all the birds that come and all the bears that come. It's feeding everything. And then I end with creator and row. And that's my creator, but it really attends to, so I wish I had a male, but I don't. And another time. And all the flies would attract salmon to them. They were all made, like he told me, this one is made to attract salmon in Alaska. And they will all catch salmon. So again, the whole idea of man being somebody who's after these fish, and that even when they fall off the fish, when they fall out of the female fish lines, and bears and ospreys and eagles and men are not far away. And then sort of triumphantly or not, I ended with a joyful hallelujah. So that's death row.